Everyone, this is Rahul Malhotra from SFDC Stop, and welcome to the fourth tutorial in Salesforce integration tutorial series. So in this tutorial we are going to explore the delete method in detail. So I have my workbench ready, and in the last tutorial we were exploring about the post method. So in this tutorial we are going to delete some of the contacts using our custom API, absolutely. So let's jump on to that. So what I'm going to do, first of all, I'm going to quickly switch on to the delete branch of my repository so that I can check out the delete code in contact resource as well as in contact resource one class. So according to the HTTP standards, the delete method is mainly used to delete some of the, you know, some of the record from our system. So what the delete method is going to do here, the delete method is going to delete any of the contact. Suppose I have a number of contacts in my org, then I'm going to delete a contact. So I have opened a contact named as Alec Bachman, and I'm going to copy its ID. So whatever the custom REST API is going to do, I'm going to pass the ID over here in the URL, and I'm going to click on execute. So it will find the contact in my Salesforce org which has this ID, and it will delete that contact, and it will give me a response that my record is deleted successfully and a success message of one. Even if I check the row response, I can see that my JSON response will be as follows. It is saying that the record is deleted successfully and the success has a value of 1. However, if I check my org again, so I can see here that this contact should be deleted. Yeah, it's deleted. So now let's jump onto the code and let's see how this API is working. So I have a class named as contact resource that I created earlier. I have a URL mapping of contact API so that whenever I'm hitting a URL ending with contact API, this class is called automatically. However, I'm choosing the delete method here from the workbench. So I have an annotation of HTTP delete to a method which is named as delete contact. So while hitting this API, I mean, I have told this earlier also, that whenever we are hitting an API, our custom API of Salesforce, we don't need to specify the method name because we have an annotation that works out for us. So for this method named as delete contact, I have an annotation of HTTP delete. So whenever Salesforce is going, I mean, whenever we are going to hit a custom API of Salesforce with the delete method, so Salesforce is going to search according to the URL mapping. And in this class, Salesforce is going to search for the methods that have an annotation of HTTP delete, and you can have only a single method with a particular annotation so that you can have only a single method with an annotation of HTTP delete. So it is automatically going to, you know, run the code inside this method. So inside this method, what we are doing, we have created a response map of string of string. So if you can see the response, you can see here that it is kind of a map. It has a key value pair, like the key is message and the value is record deleted successfully. Next, the key is success and the value is one. So to form the response, I have created a map of string and string, which is known as response map. And next, what I'm doing, I'm getting the request using restContext.request, and I'm initializing a variable of restContext, a variable of restRequest class, which is known as the context request with the actual request. So the restContext is nothing but a context class, which is predefined in Salesforce. It gives us the request or the response, that is the actual request or the actual response, which is going through while calling the API. So restContext.request will give us the incoming request that is coming to our system, and I have initialized a variable of restRequest class from there. Next, what I have done, after initializing a variable, I have actually got the request URI from the contactRequest class, and I have passed it to a string. So once I have the request URI, URI is nothing but the you can say the part after the apex rest mainly, I think. So I mean, let's do one thing. I am going to add a system.debug here, and let's see what is a contact request URI actually. I mean, I know that it's the part after the apex rest, but let's see it ourselves. So I'm quickly going to save it, and meanwhile, let's open our debug logs and check what happens when I delete a contact. So I'm going to open my developer console here. I'm going to choose a contact to delete. Okay, so our developer console is ready. Our code is being deployed. and I'm going to open a contact. Why is it taking so much time? Okay, so my contact is here. I'm going to copy its ID and use it in workbench to delete another contact. And this time I have added a system.debug. So let's execute this. And I'm going to delete another contact, which is again of name Alec Bachman. So I have multiple contacts with the same name. Okay, so I'm going to the logs and I have a log here, which is of the operation that is my contact API with the contact ID. And I'm going to check the debug part. So let's click on debug only and see what we have. So we have this ending that is slash contact API slash my ID. So you can see here that when I'm going to delete a contact, I'm getting the request URI from the contact request, and the request URI is nothing but the part after FX REST, that is slash contact API slash the ID. This is what we have got in the debug, right? Slash contact API slash our contact ID. So this is our contact, you can say the request URI, which is coming from the request. So I have got this request URI and I have stored it in a string named as contact request URI. So next what I am doing is I am actually finding the contact ID, which whose contact I have to delete. So I need to find the ID from this request URI, because request URI consists of my contact API as well as the ID. So I need to find this particular ID and use that. So how I'm finding that, I have called the substring method in this contact request URI string, and I'm finding the index of the slash which is coming at the end. So if I see this request URI, it has two slashes. First slash is there and the second slash is there. So if I quickly do one thing, I'm going to copy and paste this request URI. So you can see that, if I have an array of string or if I have an array of characters or something, then I have the indexes as follows: 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Sorry, 10 is going to be here, 11. So, this slash is coming at the index 10, and this 0 is coming at an index 11, right? So, what I'm finding through my code I'm doing here is I'm finding the last index of slash. So, the last index of slash is mainly 10. However, my ID starts from index number 11. So I need to find the ID, the index of the ID, right? So I'm adding one in here and then using the substring method to find the substring. So what it will give me this particular substring, which is starting from the index after the index of the last slash. So the index of the last slash is 10, and then I'm adding plus one and then I'm finding the substring. To just confirm this once, I'm going to copy and paste this inside a debug. So let's add another debug here, system.debug, and I'm going to add this. So let's check out what is our index of last slash plus one, and I'm finding the substring from here till the end, because in the substring I need to give two indexes of using which I need to find the substring. If I don't give another index, it will take it to the end. So if I consider my string, like it's like slash contact API slash 0 or something, so if I have this particular starting index of 0, then it will take it to the end. So my code is successfully deployed. Let's find another contact that I want to delete. I think this contact is not deleted yet. No, it's already deleted. Let's take this contact then. Okay, so this contact is present. I'm going to copy and paste the ID in here, and this time I should have my index in the logs. So let's see if this contact is deleted. Its contact is deleted successfully, and I have another log. If I check this log quickly, I should have my index here. That is the index of the last slash plus one. So let's click on debug only. So this index is 12. So if I check my index of last slash, it should be, it's starting from 1. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. I think I have an issue. It's starting from 0 only. So 0th is this. 1 is C. 2 is for O. 3 is for N. 4 is for T. 5 is for A. C is for 6. T is for 7th. A is for 8. Yeah, P is for 9th, and 10th is for this, and 11th is for slash. Okay, so 10th is coming here, 11th is coming here. So Okay, so this is my index 12. So index 12 is the index of the starting 0 of this substring. So I am finding the substring which is starting from the index 12, which is my starting index, and I haven't specified the ending index, so it will take it to the end. So in this way, I am going to get the ID from here. So if I do this substring, apply the substring method to the ID which is starting from 12. So I'll get the ID, and I have passed that ID using id.value of into the ID data type. So finally, what I have done, I have created a new contact instance using contact object is equal to new contact, and I have given the ID as contact ID, which I got from the substring, and I have added a try catch here because I'm trying to delete the contact. So if the contact is deleted successfully, I have added two values in my response map. Response map is nothing but the map of string and string that I created earlier. So the response map will have a key of success and a value of 1, and a key of message and a value of record deleted successfully. And in case my contact is not deleted successfully or there is an exception, so in that case my response map will have a success of 0 and a message of whatever the message exception has there. Okay, so I'm sorry. Okay. So what do we need to do now? We have already seen that whenever my contact is deleted successfully, I have a success of 1 and a message of record deleted successfully. Now let's jump on to an error. So I can add a validation to stop the contact from deleting, or I mean I can add some custom logic also. So what I can do, I can pass the wrong ID in here because I know that this ID is of a contact that is already deleted, right? If I check in my org using this ID, I can confirm that this contact is already deleted. Okay, so what if I try to delete a contact that is already deleted in Salesforce? Let's try this out. So I'm going to click on execute again, and I have the delete method here. So I got the success as 0, and my message is delete field. First exception on row 0 with ID is, first error is entity is deleted. So it is showing me a message that the record that you are trying to delete is already deleted in Salesforce. So in this case, an exception occurred. I'm sorry for the issue. So an exception occurred. The success has a value of 0 and a message has a value of exception.getMessage, whichever is coming. I mean, this is the message which is coming from the exception. Okay. So this is how our delete API is working. The delete method is working in our API. So what I have done is that I just got the request URI, which is nothing but the data, or you can say the URL path, which is following the apex rest. And finally, after getting the request URI, I got the last index of slash plus 1. So the last index of slash was this, which was 11, and plus 1 is the index of 0, which was 12. So I got a starting index from here, and I used the substring method into my request URI. I have given the starting index as 12 here, and I have not given any ending index, so it is taking it to the end. And at the end, I only have the request, or you can say the contact ID. So I got the contact ID, I passed it into the ID format using id.value of, and I created an instance of contact with a particular ID to delete. I deleted the contact, and if the contact is deleted successfully, set up the response map accordingly, and if there is an exception, I set up the response map accordingly again. So this is useful whenever I have to delete a single contact, but we can have multiple scenarios, right? What if I need to delete multiple contacts? Suppose I need to delete 5 contacts at a row, or I need to delete 3 contacts. Let's say I have Bachman Ulrich, I have Bartim, and I have Xavier Bridge, and I need to delete all these contacts at once. So let's do one thing. I'm going to paste these contact IDs onto my another API, which is contact API 1. So we'll jump onto the code, but let's see how it's working. So I have my first contact ID, and I have a comma here, and I have my second contact ID. And I'm going to copy my third contact ID. I'm adding a comma here at the end, and I'm adding the third contact ID, and I'm going to click on execute. So let's see how our contact API 1 is going to handle deletion of multiple contacts. So I have the response here. So it is saying that my first contact is deleted successfully, which was with ID this. My second contact is not deleted because Your attempt to delete Mr. Tim Barr could not be completed because it has associated with the following cases. So I think there is some validation rule or something that if the contact is associated with cases, it cannot be deleted. Okay, and my third contact is again deleted successfully. So let's check out the contacts that are deleted first of all. So this was my first contact, which was deleted successfully. So it's deleted. My contact Tim Barr is not deleted successfully. So I think it should be here. Come on, okay. And my third contact is again deleted, which is Xavier Bilch. Yeah, it's again deleted successfully. So I mean, I can pass as many contacts as I want in a comma separated manner, and I'll have separate results for each and every contact. I mean, I can have partial success too, right? Even if all these contacts are going to be deleted in a single transaction, still I have partial success. Like one or three contacts were deleted, however the middle one was not deleted successfully. So it's again present in Salesforce. So how can we create such kind of API, custom API, where we can delete the contacts, delete a number of contacts, and that too with partial success? So let's jump onto the code for this. What I have done, I have created another class named as contact resource one, like done previously, and it has a URL mapping of contact API one, so that whenever I'm going to hit an API ending with contact API one, Salesforce is going to find the classes with a URL mapping of contact API one, and it is going to come to this class, which is contact resource one class, and finally it is checking the method that is used. So the delete method is used. So Salesforce is going to find the methods in this class, which has an annotation of HTTP delete. So Salesforce is going to come to this method, which is named as delete contacts, and it is going to execute all the code which is inside this. So if you see the response, or if I can show you the JSON response, you can see that I have an array here in the response, and in the array I have a number of objects. Like this is the first JSON object, this is the second JSON object, and this is the third JSON object. Like it is shown here, I have an array, or you can say a list, and I have different items in the list, that is the JSON objects. And each object has two parameters, a success and a message, a success and a message, a success and a message. So what is going, or you can say what is happening in the background, I have created a list of response wrapper, and my response wrapper class is an inner class that have two you can say parameters, or I should say data members. One is a success and second is the message, and both the data members are of type string. So a list of response wrapper is being returned from my delete contacts method, which is automatically called when an HTTP delete request is made. So this list of response wrapper is returned, and it has two parameters, a success and a message. I mean, each object of this response wrapper will have two variables. So what I have done to form the response, first of all, I have initialized a list of response wrapper class, and I have named it as response wrapper list. Then I got my request using restContext.request like we have done previously. So my you can say instance of restRequest class is initialized, and it has the actual request. Next, I need to get the request URI, because you know that all the contact IDs are present in my request URI itself. So the REST request URI in this case will start from Apex REST and will end at the end. Okay, so I got the request URI, and like previously, if you remember, I got the last index of slash plus one. So this, in this case also, I am getting the substring, which is the last index of slash plus one. So this will give me the substring which is starting from 0 till the end. So it will give me all the IDs. And finally, what I am doing, I am splitting this substring using a comma. So all in this whole substring, you can see that it has a number of IDs that are separated by commas. So I'm splitting this substring using the split method, and I'm splitting it using a comma. So what it will do, it will just create the substring is of string type, so it will just create an array of string, and it will return me that. The split method will automatically split the strings into the number of strings that are formed by having a look at the commas, and it will return me an array of strings. So the array of strings is nothing but the contact IDs, because the strings are split using the comma, so the comma is not included in there, and I'll get 1, 2, and 3 elements in an array. So, this is the second element, and this is the third element. So I'll have the contact IDs, and then what I'm doing, I have initialized a list of contact because I'm going to delete contacts after all, right? And I have named it as contacts to delete, and then I run a for loop over the contact IDs that I got from here, from my substrings. So in each iteration of the loop, I created a new contact with a particular ID for which I have to delete that contact, and I'm going to add that contact into my contacts to delete list. So what I'm going to do, I mean, what I'm doing here in this part of code is nothing but I'm getting the contact IDs from my substring by using the split method over to the request URI, and I have the contact IDs in here, and then I'm finally iterating these contact IDs one by one, and I'm creating an instance of contact for each contact ID, and I'm going to add that instance of contact in my contact to delete list so that I can delete those contacts at once. Now what I have done, I have used database.delete method, and I have passed the contacts to delete list in this database.delete method, and have kept the value of second parameter to false. So this is an important interview question if I talk about interviews, that what is the difference between, I mean, they ask that what is the difference between delete method, I mean, I could have simply done here like delete contacts to delete. So this will also work, and but I have done here database.delete. So why I have used database.delete instead of this statement? So this is an interview question, and even you can try it yourself. But my reason of using database.delete instead of the delete is that it has a second parameter which is known as the all or none parameter. So I should write here it's all or none parameter. So what this all or none parameter do? It in this, if I specify it as true, then if there is any error in even one of the contacts in this whole list, then no contact will be deleted, everything will be rolled back. However, if I have specified this all or none parameter as false, then partial deletion will be there. That is, if I have five contacts in this list and one of the contacts has an error and the four contacts are right or ready to be deleted, then those four will be deleted and I'll get an error only in one contact. So nothing will be rolled back, the operation will be successful. So I mean, this all or none parameters specify that either all the contacts should be deleted or none of them. So if it's true, then either all will be deleted or none of them. And if it's false, then partial deletion will be there. So I want that partial deletion of contacts should be there. That is why I have kept it as false, and I have used database.delete method and passed my list of contacts to be deleted in here. So what this method returns, it returns an array of database.delete result that I can iterate and finalize my response. So I'm iterating this delete results object, you can say, or instance of my database.delete result array. So in this array, I have an instance of database.delete result, which is known as delete result, which is initialized each time. So what I'm checking, because I need to, if you check the return type, I'm returning a list of response wrapper, right? So I need to create multiple response wrappers added to a list for each contact. So for each contact, I'm creating an instance of response wrapper, which is known as wrapper, inside my delete result loop. And I'm checking if the delete result was successful using the isSuccess method. So it is just an inbuilt method. You can check out the delete result class in the documentation of Salesforce. It will have an isSuccess method. So this shows us that whether the operation was successful or not. So if the contact was deleted successfully, I'm initializing the wrapper as the success as one and the message as successfully deleted contact with ID, and I'm getting the ID from the delete result. I mean the ID of the contact which was deleted. So if you can check my response here, you can see that in case of successful deletion, I have the success as one, which I have set here, and I have the message as successfully deleted contact with ID, and then my contact ID of the deleted contact. So the contact ID of deleted contact is coming from delete result.getID. So I have set my response using this. And in case the contact was not deleted, my success has a value of 0. So my success has a value of 0. And I'm iterating over delete results.getErrors. So delete results.getErrors gives us nothing but a list of database.error. So using that list, I'm iterating that list of database.error, and each time for each iteration, I'm getting an error object. So what I'm checking, I mean, I have a wrapper.success and a wrapper.message, right? So I'm overwriting the wrapper.message. So what I'm doing is I am using the wrapper.message and I'm doing it as wrapper.message is equal to the following error has occurred for contact with ID, then the ID of the contact, and then I'm saying the status code, the get message. I'm using the get status code and get message method to get the status code and messages. And finally, I'm saying that contact fields that affected this error by getting the fields. So this is the standard, you can say the pretty standard standard format of getting the errors. It is available in the Salesforce documentation. So I've just used some of the methods that are predefined in my database.error class, which is the get status code, get message, get fields. So this is how I am forming the error, that the following error has occurred for contact with ID this. So this is our first statement. And then I'm getting the status code and the message. So it is showing me that the status code is delete failed, and the message is your attempt to delete Mr. Tim Bar could not be completed because it is associated with the following cases, this and this. And finally, I have the final line, that is contact fields that affected this error. And then I have the get fields method, which is returning nothing because there were no fields particularly that were affected. Okay, so I'm forming the error message from here. And finally, what I'm doing, so if I just hide this for a second, I can show you that within this for loop, what I'm doing, I'm forming my success message or my error message, and then I'm adding that wrapper to my response wrapper list. So this new wrapper which is created in the loop is added to the response wrapper list, and finally I'm returning this response wrapper list in the response. So this response wrapper list is returned to me in the response that consists of the success messages as well as the error messages that are formed within the for loop. So this is how we can delete multiple contacts when I'm dealing with multiple contacts, this is how we can delete. I mean, we can have the IDs comma separated, we can get the request URI again, then we can again find the contact IDs from following the end of the request URI, I mean the end of the last slash plus one. Then I'm using the split method divide the contact IDs and getting a string of contact IDs, string array of contact IDs. Then I'm forming different contact objects and adding it to a contact list. Then I'm passing that list to be deleted using the database.delete method that allows partial deletion. Finally, I'm getting the result of deletion and I'm forming my response wrapper for each delete result. And I'm adding my response wrapper to the response wrapper list. And finally, I'm returning my response wrapper list in the response. So, I mean, we have seen that in this tutorial, how we can delete a single contact and how we can delete multiple contacts using the delete method, which is the standard method by HTTP to perform the deletion operation. So this is how, I mean, this custom API is working. So if you want to see or read about this API in detail, you can go to my blog at SFDC Stop Integration Tutorial Part 4. And here you will have everything written over there, and all the thing that I have said is written over there properly. So you have a proper documentation of this along with the code. However, if you just want to have a look at the code, you can go to my GitHub repository, that is github.com/rahulmalhotra/sfdc-integration-tutorial. You can go to the delete branch and you will have your contact resource as well as your contact resource one class, in which the contact resource will have a delete contact method, which is useful for deleting a single contact. However, the contact resource one class will have a delete method, which is used to delete multiple contacts. So this is all the code that I have used in this tutorial series. Okay, so if you like this tutorial, don't forget to let me know your feedback in the comment section below, and don't forget to share it. However, in the next tutorial, we are going to learn about, let's move down here. We are going to learn about the put method in detail. So till then, I hope you had a good day. Bye-bye.